DeRozan with it. Picked up by Teague. And DeRozan, here we go. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
Well, now's the time to do it. Keep attacking that rim.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks.
Rivas Vasquez, a 6'6 point guard out of Venezuela by way of the University of Maryland, is really a good passer and playmaker. Plays with a swagger and moxie that you love to see. You know, a couple seasons back, this guy averaged 9 assists a game.
Hawks making a switch here. Korver's checked in. And Toronto also making a switch. Kyle Lowry, he's checked in for Vasquez. On the wing, DeRozan. Johnson sends the screen for DeRozan. Nice work there, coming off the screen. DeRozan's got 10 points in the game. And Vasquez with great size, Steve, for the point guard position.
Not an elite athlete, so he sometimes lacks the quickness to guard opposing point guards, but his height, his strength, and his grit and anticipation makes him really a viable option against a lot of different matchups in the league.
It's still going.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game right now.
Clark, there is a swagger out here on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either.
That's right.
Those are phenomenal dunks to watch. So much fun.
They shoot again. Shot is good, and the Toronto lead is cut down to just 6 points with the basket for Milton.
Well, that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active, be energetic, and react as soon as the shot goes up.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto. Their last game, a win against San Antonio, looking to carry that into this one.
And they made their mark defensively that day. That was what was, I think, most impressive. Really caused a lot of problems in the paint.
Well, they spent a lot of that game in the air and got their hands on a lot of shots.
With this break, a look at our 2K leaderboard and the top passing centers and power forwards over the course of the past 10 games. Fifth best is Al Horford.
Well, it takes tremendous feel for the game to be able to make the passes these big guys are capable of making out of that low post area.
Absolutely, Steve. I mean, these fellas play in the high traffic area on the court, so the passing lanes for them are a lot tighter than they are out on the perimeter. Not nearly as much room.
Now let's send it to Doris from the sideline.
Oh, thank you, Kevin. Well, DeMar DeRozan, with great size at the shooting guard position, recently he's looked to exploit that advantage in the post. He said, quote, "I look at guys like Kobe, and as they started to get older, they got better in the low block. I look at them as, quote, if I get better at it now, that's going to be a benefit for me later." Guys, he's already seeing the dividends paid.
Getting close range buckets and getting to the line, Doris. That's helping his efficiency. Thanks. Ross with a wide open look. And he can extend the lead to double digits.
Terrence Ross, I think, has a chance to be an elite 3-and-D player at the NBA level. Has three-point shooting and defense for the uninitiated. Tremendous athleticism and a beautiful stroke make him an entertaining player to watch.
Looking at who's out there now for the Hawks. Eldon Brand's checked in for Horford. Scott comes in for Paul Millsap. And it's Schroeder in for Jeff Teague. And Toronto making a change here. Hansbrough's checked in. And Terrence Ross can make some highlights, Steve, around the rim.
Yeah, so athletic. You'd like to see him get to the line a bit more. I think he has a tendency to settle, but, you know, as he is, a pretty efficient scorer.
Here's Schroeder, and a missed layup.
That's the kind of defense required when he's got the ball near the hoop, and they were right in his face.
The kick out to Williams. And the Raptors miss again. It's stolen by Hansbrough. Patterson passes it to Lowry. Rebounded by Brand. They can go 2-for-1.
Yeah, they need to play it smart. Make sure you get a good shot first and then maybe a second possession.
Here's Schroeder. Let's the three fly. Good work defensively by Lowry. Outside Williams. And the officials call a traveling violation. So both teams changing it up here. Here's Schroeder. 8 points his last outing. Scott up top. Out to the right wing. The clock runs out and we're heading to halftime. Raptors lead by 8. Time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow, right here on 2K Sports. Come on. And the second half about to start here in just a few moments. A fantastic game from DeMar DeRozan so far.
I know we've said this many times before, but I'll say it again. He had a great first half, just an explosive offensive display there.
At the end of the day, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half he had. He can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
Millsap at power forward with Horford at center. On the wings, Korver and Carroll. And it's Teague in the one spot. They're the group for Mike Budenholzer starting the second half. They get it back. Outside for Lowry. And DeMar DeRozan the bucket on the assist by Lowry. 15 points for DeMar DeRozan.
DeMar DeRozan is starting to piece it together. I mean, we see him up in his scoring average. He's shooting it better. He's passing the ball with more confidence. He's becoming more efficient. You know, after a big extension from the Raptors, I think they've got to be pleased with his progress.
Yeah, the referee's all over that one.
No doubt about it. Clearly a foul. Nothing to argue about there.
And guys, when you look at DeRozan, where can he take the next step?
Well, he has the physical tools to be an elite perimeter defender. He's made strides, definitely, but you know, he has the potential, I think, to be even better than what he is right now.
Let's go to our sideline reporter, Doris Burke. Doris, what do you have?
Well, Kevin, the Atlanta Hawks, a team that looks to spread the floor with shooting. Coach Mike Budenholzer said we don't want to just be a three-point shooting team. We want to get to the rim first. By creating that space, we give our guards and our bigs a chance to attack. If the paint is taken away, we'll look for our shooters. Good strategy, Kevin.
Coach Bud coming from San Antonio, Doris. The Hawks trying to create that same kind of spacing. And the Raptors call time here. Change here. Moss is checked in. Already it's February. Let's see how the East is matching up. You look at Toronto. And of course the Atlanta Hawks. They're tied right now. And Toronto has possession. They lead by 11, the largest margin of the game. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Let's go. And again, Toronto, no luck.
And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
Horford, no luck.
It has not been an ideal start to the second half. They've missed three of their first four. Hawks coach Mike Budenholzer grew up around the game. His father coached high school and college basketball for 25 years, and Mike got into coaching pretty much immediately after graduating from college. Sounded like a guy who knew what he wanted to do.
Time called here. The Hawks decide to talk it over. You gotta like what DeMar DeRozan has done in this game.
He's on fire, and they needed to put their heads together to figure out how to get the ball out of his hand.
The last 10 games, these big men have been the NBA's best at the charity stripe. In fourth position, Al Horford.
Well, a lot of these big men take the confidence they have in the paint straight to the free throw line.
Yep, some of them do that, exactly, and we can see the reason why in those numbers. In general, the composure of all those players show up at the free throw line.
Here's Korver for three. Nice D from DeRozan.
Tough three-point try there with a hand in his face.
Boy, you'd be lucky to make that one against great defense. You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
You know, last game he turned in a really nice performance at the charity stripe.
Yeah, it really stands out when you look back at the numbers from that one.
Guys, he is close to where he was last year in that category, but his numbers are still down just a skosh. Amir Johnson is one of the longest tenured Toronto Raptors in his sixth season with the team now. And with the departures of Bargnani and Ed Davis, he's assumed the starting role, and I think he's responded quite well to it.
And it's slammed in by T. Amazing hops, exploding to the bucket.
Kevin, you don't expect to see that coming from the point guard position.
No way.
Boy, can he elevate it. That size, that's impressive.
Back to Lowry. He dishes it to DeRozan. The Raptors need to get a shot off. Here's Ross. And another basket for Toronto. And Amir Johnson has said he wants to play the rest of his career, Steve, in Toronto.
Well, he's really embraced the community, connected with the fans. And, you know, for people who haven't been to Toronto, they don't know what they're missing. It's a wonderful city, and the support that the Raptors get is just awesome. I mean, they fill up the building. They even fill up the park right outside the building to watch the games during the playoffs. It's awesome.
Looking at who's out there now for the Hawks. Eldon Brands checked in for Horford. Mike Scott comes in for Paul Millsap. Kent Bazemore is checked in for Damari Carroll. And it's Dennis Schroeder in for Teague.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised to see them double up here.
I agree. And they haven't been able to succeed with single coverage to this point.
Vasquez, he's checked in for Toronto. Well, the Toronto Raptors guys looking at a rebrand for a team starting next season to celebrate their 20th anniversary in the league. Boy, time flies. New colors, Steve, and a new logo.
Yeah, they'd even considered a name change but decided to stick with the Raptors. But a chance perhaps to go with that, you know, bird of prey connotation rather than a dinosaur.
And you go back to when the Raptors came into existence in 1995. It was Jurassic Mania, thanks to the hit movie at that time. That influenced the fan vote when it came to the team's name. But I think the Tyrannosaurus theme may soon go extinct.
Well, you talk about the branding of this Raptors team. Of course, we saw the Toronto.